All right, young hominins, here's your introduction to the Unit 4 class visual activity points. In this one, you're going to be submitting a JPEG of your finished activity the same way you did in Unit 3 for the primate intermembral index. All right, as you can see right here, hominin review sheet, need this pages 1 and 2 for this one, and on paper. Yeah, better than not, but I know some of you don't have a printer, so have it pulled up so that you can see it. The hominin mandible here, which I did a quick video review of the differences between the two groups that's posted in Canvas, is just here because I think it looks cool. Okay, let me move it out of the way. All right, for this, you're going to need these pages, and we're going to put them to the side here. You're going to need a ruler or a straight edge in order to make this look tidy and useful, a pencil, maybe a couple different colors of pens, and probably a highlighter. All right, so the activity here. As you can see, I already started this by putting a long line at the upper edge of a longer piece of paper. I did have another long one similar to the ones we used in class for the unit 2 diagrams for the DNA molecule, but an open piece of bag, whatever you've got. All right, long one across the top, a much shorter one here on this edge. You're going to be creating a timeline version of notes for all of the species that are on page 1 on the hominin review sheet, and then the shorter line is page 2 on the hominin review sheet. Remember, page 2 is much, much younger, so make your timeline younger. Then, as I did here, go ahead and mark in and write it out yourself. Don't cut and paste. Cut and paste is not in your brain. Writing things by hand is in your brain. It'll make all other forms of review and answering questions for the exam go much, much more clearly. As I mentioned in the other video that's already posted, with the hominin review sheet, trying to look up the answers for this test, not gonna work. It just doesn't. The names are too similar. The hominin review sheet, see, it's too crowded with names and data. You won't have enough time to look everything up. So you wanna make your own notes sheet that you can use to reinforce your memory as you go. Okay, so the things that I haven't put on here, but you're gonna go ahead and do it when you work yours, is the times, a bullet list coming down because you're going to add some specifics for the group as you go, and then across the top you're just going to want to put the names in. And again, writing out the names is by hand is the best way to remember them. It's creating, it's moving, it's seeing, and again, as we go on to these, the next one would be Ardipithecus ramidus. Then we go into the Australopithecus, Australopithecus animensis, afarensis, Kinyanthropus platyops, Africanus, Australopithecus prometheus, and so forth as you go. So you put the names up here, then keep everything tidy, right? Because just like we did with the DNA molecule, tidy really makes a big difference when you're trying to remember things. And then you're gonna wanna put in some of the basics. Time, name, you've got that part. Then I would put in location for your first bullet, right? Like a drop-down menu. You all are the drop-down menu information group, more so than outlines, which is why I'm not suggesting you make an outline. Put the location for all of these. They're going to be east or south. There, fill them out this way. The same down here. Do they have a nickname? Not all of them do, but for instance here, we've got Artie. For the next one, don't really have one. For Afarensis, though, you've got Lucy, you've got Silam, you've got the Dakika child, there'll be quite a few. Then do height, weight. I did that in the other video for these. Now, the thing that's gonna make some of these easier, height, weight for male, versus female, is that for all of these, you're going to use the same one. So all I would do is write that down once, if we've got the data, which we do have the data from these, and then take a highlighter and just run them all this way. so that you know that they're linked, so that each one is going to be the same note right here. And then for the last one, nicknames will all be different, right? And then for the last one, I would probably put whatever you might think might be left over. Only last bullet point, there'll be a couple of here and here where we do have stone tool evidence. You're going to see that in chapter 11. So location, oldest fossil, does it have a nickname, height and weight for males and females, and then they will go along on this particular group. Now I'm going to swap this out for the next part because I've already done it and I want this to be a quick video. So once you get that part finished, it's going to also be really, really helpful to do like I did right here. I'm going to run it right here to place your own diagram labeled with the key terms for anatomy. It'll be in the PowerPoint. In chapter 10 PowerPoint, there's a few anatomical issues here. You can see that I've done these two already, drawing it yourself, labeling it, and including it next to the species where that physical characteristics are present is just going to anchor it in your memory, and you'll find the whole thing going smoother. Plus, I will find out that you've actually been personally working on the information, not relying on just trying to look up things from the internet. And as I mentioned in the last one, we do have requirements that you are participating in class for a certain amount of time for this. So you will find something very similar to these, but be sure you have labeled on here what platycephalic means, what prognathic means, and what the cranial capacity for the group. And for these, again, another yellow line, 450. For the robusts, again, page 2 on the hominin review sheet, use your own colors or whatever it is, make this look cartoonishly huge in the jaw. Again, as I mentioned in the other video, for longer. And be sure that you know that the sagittal crest, a extremely widely flaring zygomatic, and these megadont molars, all three of these go together, which is why I've labeled them in the same color. Once you get that done, again, you all, your name in bold so that I know you are not just turning in somebody else's work for that, and then JPEG and submit. All right, thanks.